Some members of parliament with about 20 policemen guarding them.
Members of the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament today quizzed police on sending officers to guard VIPs as Uganda grapples with shortage of police personnel.
These people who have three, four, five police officers guarding them, and yet you are complaining about human resource constraints. How are you addressing it? And two, is that part of the NTR?
MPs decried abuse of the police force by self-styled VIPs, with some using officers to shield themselves from being arrested by their creditors.
I see members, some members of parliament with about 20 policemen guarding them. They call themselves what? The VIPs and others. VVVIPs. Now, that means VVIPs is depriving the poor.
MPs said renting out police services to VIPs is another scheme for corruption, as senior police officers get a lot of money through charging fees over and above what is reported in police's books of accounts.
Because people lobby to go and provide guard services outside, there is a hidden pay element where a police officer gets about 300,000, and where he goes to guard, he gets 1 million. And that 1 million is you pay back.
Are they paying for the extra guards, including yourself, with the entitlement? How many are you entitled to? For the extra extras, do you pay for them?
However, in their defense, the Deputy Inspector General of Police, Major General Geoffrey Katsigazi Tumusime, revealed that most deployments are done under directives from above.
Sometimes this comes as a directive to police to deploy. And sometimes it is beyond I don't remember the year when the president addressed parliament on security. There was a specific request by parliamentarians that they be provided with escort.
He, however, assured the committee that they have started reviewing the police policy on guarding of VIPs to weed out cases of abuse and mitigate the deficit caused.
We are reviewing to look at, because you see, security threats have a time limit. Some of them have time limits. Maybe you had a deployment here, you needed some security.
Agri Wunyi, the Undersecretary of the Uganda Police Force, took a swipe at Parliament, accusing the August House of hogging a big number of police manpower, including guards, drivers, and patrol vehicles.
You have our drivers, you have guards, you have vehicles.
That's
with
the police peddling.
So I'm just trying to tell you that not only Parliament, but also the whole of government.
Meanwhile, Uganda police was grilled over causing wasteful expenditure to government by delaying to delete 380 staff who reached retirement age from the payroll. Money amounting to 1.79 billion shillings was paid out to this category of people.
Audit testing revealed that 380 staff continued to receive salaries amounting to 1.7 billion after their retirement date.
The 380.
Mm-hmm.
So when we computed their pension, we deducted the months they had earned salary.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.